So hello students, till now we have completed our CRT displays and all types of CRT monitors, display, lookup table, LCD, LEDs. So let's study about the input devices. So what are input devices? So it is the hardware that is used to transfer inputs to the computer. So the data can be in the form of text, graphics, sound and text output device display data from the memory of the computer. So output can be text, numeric, data, line, polygon and other object. We can see we will see this in the upcoming slides. And this is the whole process of input output. So first of all, what happens that the user gives some input to the input device such as a keyboard and mouse, just like I am clicking to this keyboard and making this arrow. And this after this instruction is given by the user, the instruction passes to the CPU memory, and after the CPU memory, the memory processes the data, which the raw inputs which was given by the user, it is then processed and sent to the display devices. And once the display device gets the data, it results in processing, which is in human acceptable form. That means that human can understand that language or that picture through their naked eyes. So what are some of the input devices? So they are keyboard, mouse, trackball, space ball, joystick, light pen, digitizer, touch panels, voice recognition system and image scanner. So most of these we know, but let me state each and every input devices a little bit. So first one is keyboard. So it is the most commonly used input device, and the data is entered by pressing the set of keys. All the keys are labeled, and in a modern keyboard it's 101 keys or 103, 105, it depends upon the keyboard. And the keyboard has alphabetic or as well as numeric keys and some special keys also. So what are the numeric keys? They are 0 to 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 to 9. Alphabetic key such as A to Z and capital A to Z with shift. Special control keys, control, shift, alt. There are certain special symbols, cursor key, functions key and numeric keyboard also. So let's move on to the functions of keyboard. So what are the functions of keyboard? That it is alphanumeric keyboards are used in CAD, and keyboards are available with special features, line screen, coordinate entry, menu selection or graphic functions. And special purpose keyboards are available having buttons, dials and switches, and dials are used to enter scalar values. It also enters real numbers. Buttons and switches are used to enter predefined function values. What are the advantages of keyboard? So it is suitable for entering numeric data, and function keys are a fast and effective method of using commands with fewer errors. So there are certain disadvantages also. So this keyboard is not suitable for graphics input. So this is the disadvantage of keyboard. And the next input device is mouse. So mouse is a pointing device and used to position the pointer on the screen. It is a small palm size box, or we can say that it is a small palm size, very handy. So there are two or three depression switches on the top. The movement of the mouse along the X axis helps in the horizontal movement of the cursor, and the movement along the Y axis helps in the vertical movement of the cursor of the screen. So the mouse cannot be used to enter text, therefore they are used in conjunction with the keyboard. It is only used for clicking or selecting something in the screen. So what are the advantages? It is easy to use, and it is not very expensive. So let's move on to the next input device, that is trackball. So it is a pointing device and it is similar to a mouse. This is mainly used in notebook or laptop computer instead of a mouse. So this is a ball which is half inserted, and by changing figures on the ball, the pointer can be moved. So advantages, it is stationary, so it does not require much space to use it. and compact it is of compact size. The next input device is space ball. So it is similar to trackball, but it can move in six directions, where trackball can only move in two directions, the left or right or top or bottom. So the movement is recorded by the strain gauge. The strain gauge is applied with the with pressure, and it can be pushed and pulled in various directions. So the ball has a diameter around 7.6 cm and the ball is mounted in the base using rollers. 1/3 of the ball is an inside box and the rest is outside the box. So what are the applications of space ball? So let us see. It is used for three-dimensional positioning of the object, and it is used to select various functions in the field of virtual reality. It is applicable in CAD applications. Animation is also done using space ball, and it is used in the area of simulation and modeling. So let's move on to the next input device, that is joystick. We used to play joystick in playing games, and it is also a pointing device which is used to change cursor position on the monitor screen. And it is a stick having a spherical ball at its both lower and upper end. You can see this in the image here and here. Both are having the spherical balls, and the lower spherical ball moves in a socket, and the upper spherical ball is used to control control the joystick through our hand. So it can be changed in all four directions, and the functions of a joystick is similar to that of a mouse, and it is mainly used in CAD and playing computer games. So let's move on to the next input device, that is light pen. So light pen is similar to a pen, and it is a pointing device which is used to select displayed menu items or draw pictures on the monitor screen. It consists of a photo cell and an optical system placed in a small tube. When its tip is moved over the monitor screen and the pen button is pressed, its photo cell sensing element detects the screen location and sends the corresponding signals to the CPU. It is just like a pen. So when we click its pointer and points it to the screen and writes something, then it gets displayed through the system. So what are its uses? So it is used in as input coordinate positions by providing necessary arrangements. So if background color or intensity, a light pen can be used as a locator, and it can also be used as a pointer. It is used as a standard PIC device with many graphic system. It can be used as a stroke input devices, and it can be also used as evaluators. So next, move on to the next input device, that is digitizer. So the digitizer is an operator input device which contains a large, smooth and an electronic tracking device which can be changed over the surface to follow existing lines. So the electronic tracking devices contains a switch for the user to record desired X and Y coordinate positions, and the coordinate can be entered into the computer memory or stored or an offline storage medium such as magnetic tape. So the advantages of this digitizer are that drawing can easily be changed, and it provides the capability of interactive graphics. And the disadvantage is it is very costly, and it is suitable only for applications which require high resolution graphics. So no need to use in the low resolution graphics. So the next input device is touch panels. So the best example of this is our mobile phone. So touch panel is a type of display screens that has a touch sensitive transparent panel covering the screen. A touch screen registers input when a finger or other object comes in contact with the screen, and when the wave signals are interrupted by sub contacts with the screen, that located is recorded. So touch screens have long been used in military applications, and now it is being used in everyone's hand using our smartphones and palm tops or iPads. So that's all for today. थैंक यू।